Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this tutorial, I show you how to make a Wordle image and how to combine that image with a color photo of Steve Jobs to create Wordle art. Here is a quick tutorial overview. We'll start out by creating a Wordle image on the Wordle.net website. The text used was selected from quotes from Steve Jobs. I added a few other words such as Steve Jobs, Apple, Macintosh, etc. Then we'll take an image of Jobs and crop it out. Finally, we'll place Jobs in the image and make some final adjustments. To begin the project, we need a word cloud. The first step should be to create some text. Open up a plain text editor. I use Notepad. Then paste or enter your text. I use selected quotes from Steve Jobs. I added a few other words such as Steve Jobs, Apple, Macintosh, etc. If you put a tilde symbol between words or the words in a phrase, Wordle.net will group them together so that they will appear one after another. I put the tilde symbol between Steve and Jobs. I also put tildes between some of my favorite short quotes by Jobs, such as "The extra mile is such a lonely place," and "Stay hungry, stay foolish," and some others. Wordle.net will make words that appear more frequently respectively larger. The more times a word is found, the larger it will appear in WordArt. Words connected by tildes are treated as one word. I duplicated Steve Jobs and Apple a few times. This will make them appear larger in the Wordle. I also duplicated some of the quotes in order for them to appear larger in the Wordle. When you're satisfied with the text, save it as a .txt plain text file. In case you want to follow along with the Jobs word art, I've added the text I used for it in the tutorial description area or projects files. Browse to Wordle.net. Click Create. Paste the text from your text file created earlier. Press Go. A random word cloud will appear. We want to use the colors of the Apple Rainbow logo. Next, choose Color. Choose Edit Custom Palette. Change the number of colors to 5. Make the background color black, 000000. Change the 5 foreground colors to green, 61B, B46. Yellow, FDB, 827. Red, E03, A3E. Purple, 963, D97. And blue, 009, DDC. Click OK to accept the custom colors. I skipped orange, F5821F, as Wordle only allows 5 foreground colors. We'll add that color manually later. Choose the color menu again and choose Exact Palette Colors. In the Options menu, choose Font. Select Grilled Cheese BTN. Then choose Layout, choose Straighter Edges. Then Layout, Mostly Horizontal. At this point, keep pressing Re-Layout with Current Settings in the Layout menu until you find a word cloud that is fairly rectangular with not too much black space at the sides. Once you find a design you like, you can press Recolor in the Color menu to change the distribution of the palette colors in the current Wordle. It took me around 25 tries to get the one I liked. I wanted Steve Jobs horizontal and on the left side of the Wordle. Note, here are some of the shortcut keys that may be helpful. The letter E will recolor the current Wordle. The letter R will relay out the current Wordle. Control Z takes you back to the previous Wordle. And Control Y takes you forward one Wordle. The shortcut keys may not work. If you have another program such as Photoshop, which uses these shortcuts, also open in the background. When done, click the Save as Ping button. Don't type the letters E or R in any file name you choose, or you could lose the current Wordle, as these shortcut keys may be active when you are saving the Wordle. Open the Wordle picture in Photoshop. Choose Image, Image Size. Change the image resolution to 300 pixels per inch. Double-click the background layer and name it BG. Save the image as a PSD file. Next, we will make the letters and the black background separate layers. To select the letters, choose Select Color Range. Select Shadows. Check the Invert box. Zoom in to see the letters better. Move the fuzziness slider to 0. And adjust the range slider to where the letters are the clearest. I used a range of 40 for this image. Click OK to load the selection. Duplicate the selection and name the new layer Letters. Press D to select black as your foreground color. Choose the BG layer and fill it with black. Press Ctrl 0 to fit to screen. At this point, we'll change the color of the Steve Jobs word with an orange F5821F. I'll show you how to do it in case you want to make a similar change on your picture. First, we'll copy the word Steve Jobs to a new layer. Zoom in on the Steve Jobs word. Select the letters layer. Choose the magic wand tool. With a tolerance of 100, set to anti-alias and contiguous checked. Select the S in Steve. Then while holding down the Shift key, select the rest of the letters in the word Steve Jobs. When all the letters are selected, copy the selection to a new layer. Name it SJ. Now we'll delete the word off the letters layer. Move to the letters layer. Turn off the eye of the SJ layer. Control-click the SJ layer thumbnail to get a selection. Press delete to remove the selection from the letters layer. It is now only black where Steve Jobs used to be. Next, we'll adjust the SJ layer letters. Turn on the SJ layer's eye. Make the SJ layer active. Choose Select, Modify, Contract by 2 pixels. Then choose Select, Modify, Feather by 1 pixel. Choose Select, Inverse. Press Delete. Choose Select Inverse again. This will smooth out the edges of the word. change your foreground color to F5821F. Now fill your selection with the foreground color by pressing Alt Backspace. Deselect. Fit the image to the screen. If you are happy with the way the word came out, merge the SJ and letters layers. Rename it Letters. Choose File, Place Embedded to place the portrait image. Name it Jobs. Right-click and rasterize it. Next, we will cut Jobs out of the picture. The Jobs layer should be active. Turn off the Eye of the Letters layer. Select the Quick Selection tool. Drag out a selection of the face and shirt. Hold down the Alt key to subtract areas as needed. Select Refined Edge in White on White view. Check the Smart Radius box. Drag the slider to around 14.7. Move the Feather slider to 0.2 pixels. Select in the Output 2 section, select Layer Mask. Turn back on all layers eyes. If you're happy with the cutout, choose the Jobs Thumbnail Mask. Right-click and choose Apply Layer Mask. With the Jobs layer active, choose the Move tool. Zoom out a bit. Move Jobs to a position off-center. Hold down Alt plus Shift key while dragging a corner. Then resize him. We need to straighten Jobs as he is leaning on a slight angle. Place the cursor over the top right corner until the little circular arrow appears. Drag the image a little to the right until it appears more vertically straight. Change his opacity to about 87%. To make the letters over the face a little easier to see, make the letters layer active. Control-click the Jobs layer to get a selection of it. While the letters layer is still active, duplicate the selection. Name the new layer Face Letters. Next, make some final adjustments. Change the Face Letters blend mode to Hard Mix. Make the Jobs layer active. Add a Hue Saturation adjustment layer. Check the Clip To icon. Make the settings U0 Saturation plus 24, Lightness plus 4. This will give his face a little more color. Select the Face Letter layer. Add a Clipped Levels Adjustment layer to the Face Letters layer. Check the Clip To icon. I use settings of 0, 1.94, and 255. This will brighten up the letters on his face. Select the Jobs layer. Adjust opacity to 89%. Adjust as necessary for your picture. Finally, darken the Wordle background a bit to make Jobs stand out better. make the letters layer active. Add a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Select the Clip To icon. Move the brightness slider to minus 30. Here is the final Photoshop screen. Thanks for watching.